Hello everyone, I'm Brandon Ordonez from ECE31 and today I'm gonna try to perform our experiment number 6 for our digital electronics laboratory, which is entitled Basic Arithmetic Logic Gates. The objectives of this experiment are to familiarize the students with the nature of operation of basic arithmetic circuits, to stress the significance of logic gates in the internal capacity of computers. The materials needed for this experiment are our breadboard, our 5-volt power supply, our different integrated circuits and different LEDs, and our connecting wires. Let us try to perform the experiment number 6 for our digital electronics laboratory. The first part of the experiment would be building a half adder circuit. So let us try to build the circuit. I have finished building the first circuit for our experiment. The circuit used a 7486 and a 7408 integrated circuit. Now let us try to fill the tables. Upon connecting both inputs to the ground, no LED lights up. Note that the red LED represents the S output, while the yellow LED represents the C output. Upon placing input Y to the source, the red LED lights up. Upon placing input X to the source, the red LED lights up. And upon placing both inputs to the source, only the yellow LED lights up. The second part of the experiment builds a half subtractor circuit. The circuit uses a 7486 integrated circuit, a 7404 integrated circuit, and a 7408 integrated circuit. Now let us try to build the circuit. So I have finished building the circuit for the second part of the experiment. Now let us try to fill the tables. Upon placing both inputs to the ground, none of the LEDs light up. Upon placing input Y to the source, both LEDs light up. Note that the red light represents the D output, while the yellow light represents the B output. Upon placing input X to the source, with input Y to the ground, only the red LED lights up. Upon placing both inputs to the source, none of the LEDs light up. The third part of the experiment builds a full adder circuit. The circuit is a 7408 integrated circuit, a 7486 integrated circuit, and a 7432 integrated circuit. Now let us try to build the circuit. So I have finished building the third circuit for our experiment. Now let us try to fill the tables. Upon connecting all inputs to the ground, none of the LEDs light up. Upon connecting input Z to the source, only the yellow LED lights up. Note that the red LED represents the C output, while the yellow LED represents the S output. Upon connecting input B to the source, none of the LED lights up. Upon connecting inputs Y and inputs Z to the source, only the red LED lights up. Upon connecting input X to the source with input Y and Z to the ground, only the yellow LED lights up. Upon connecting inputs X and Z to the source, only the red LED lights up. Upon connecting inputs X and Y to the source, only the red LED lights up. And upon connecting all inputs to the source, both the yellow and the red LED lights up. The final part of the experiment is building a full subtractor circuit. Now let us try to build the circuit. I have finished building the fourth part of our experiment, which is a full subtractor circuit. For the results, note that the red LED represents the D output, while the yellow LED represents the B output. Now let us try to fill the tables. Upon connecting all inputs to the ground, none of the LEDs light up. Upon connecting input Z to the source, both of the LEDs light up. Upon connecting input Y to the source, both of the LEDs light up. Upon connecting inputs Y and Z to the source, only the yellow LED lights up. Upon connecting input X to the source, only the red LED lights up. Upon connecting input X and Z to the source, none of the LED lights up. Upon connecting inputs X and Y to the source, none of the LED lights up. Upon connecting all of the inputs to the source, both of the LEDs light up. These are the conclusions and the recommendations for our experiment. For the half adder and full adder circuit, note that the output S represents the sum, while the output C represents the carry for the arithmetic operation of addition. For the half adder circuit, which has two inputs, basic summing was used to determine the output S. Notably, if both inputs are 1, 1 must leave the sum as 0 and carry 1 for further addition. The same can be said with the full adder circuit, which has 3 inputs, wherein basic addition was used to determine the sum. If 2 or more inputs have values of 1, the sum would be 0 and the value of the carry would be 1. For the half subtractor and full subtractor circuits, note that the output D represents the difference, while the output B represents borrow. For the half subtractor, it can be observed that the input Y is subtracted from X. To put it simply, input X should have a greater value than input Y in order to have zero carry. It was observed from the table that subtraction of input X and input Y was performed in order to gain the results. The same can be said for the full subtractor circuit, which has 3 inputs, wherein the equation can be written as X minus Y minus Z is equal to D. The circuit also uses subtraction in order to determine the result of the circuit as seen from the tables displayed previously. Recommendations. Since the circuits are lengthy, it is recommended that you use only one piece of IC per value, since one can utilize the extra pins of the IC to save board space. Simulate before starting the experiment to know the desired output. Prepare extra connecting wires and check if they are shorted. So that is it for our experiment number 6 on Digital Electronics Laboratory, entitled Basic Arithmetic Logic Gates.